beneficial to them and make sure that it's not going to pose any cause any problems. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel, it's Clotting Rags, and today I have some advice for you if you are looking to adopt a special needs cat. Now, special needs cats can range from cats who are deaf or blind or have had an amputation to ones with certain conditions like maybe diabetes or, as you'll see in this video, a kitten with cerebral palsy. Taking on a special needs cat is not a decision to make lightly. They are going to have a lot more needs than a regular cat, and you need to make sure that you're going to be able to provide for them. So I just have some general hints and tips on if you're thinking of caring for a special needs cat. Now, I visited a friend recently who not only has a blind cat, but she also has a kitten with cerebral palsy. She's absolutely adorable. She's called Wobbles, which is really sweet. And you will see her in this video. Now, you need to make sure that your home is suitable for a cat with special needs before you get it. So you need to prepare your home for your special needs cat. So for example, if you have a blind cat, you need to make sure your furniture placement doesn't get moved around too much. A blind cat will navigate their surroundings and become familiar with them while they're settling in. And if you keep moving furniture around, they're going to become disorientated. If you have a cat with mobility issues, you need to make sure that all of the resources are easily accessible to them. So litter trays need to have low sides, and their food and drinks need to be easily accessible to them. Now, in the case of Wobble, they have a little cage that she goes in when there's no one else in the house. This just means that she is kept somewhere safe. It's where her bed is and she has access to water and resources. But it just makes sure that she doesn't get into any harm and no one's there. She's caged in. It's really rather nice. It's a bit like a VIP section. and it just makes sure that she doesn't harm herself when no one's around. Now, if you are going to adopt a special needs cat but also have other pets at home, you need to make sure the introductions are done properly. Your special needs cat is going to be a little more vulnerable, so you need to make sure that they are going to be safe. Now, when it comes to introducing your special needs cat to your other pets, they need to be slow and supervised. Start with having them in a small room on their own so they become accustomed to their surroundings and get used to you. Now, you can give them regular treats when you come in so that they can associate you and that house with good things. When it comes to playtime and interaction with your other pets, like I said, make sure that it is supervised and it's slow. Slowly introduce them as you would any other cat, but just keep an extra special eye on your special needs cats. They might get a little bit stressed out, a little bit upset, and it's possible your cat, other animals might be a little bit rambunctious with them. If you don't think your special needs cat and your other pets are going to get along, it's a decision you're going to have to really think about. Now, there may be certain behavioural issues that may come up with special needs cats, and you need to familiarise yourself with these. Now, the best thing to do is talk to the people that you are adopting the cat from, or talk to your vet. They'll be able to tell you what to expect when you're getting a special needs cat. You need to make sure all their resources are accessible to them and that you give them enough time to become familiar with their surroundings. So if you have a blind cat, they may miss the litter box a little bit when they're first getting used to it. But don't worry, they will adapt to their surroundings and hopefully there won't be many behavioural issues. Now, it's quite likely that a special needs cat won't be able to go outside, so you're going to have to make sure that they don't get bored or frustrated at home. Not being able to go outside may mean that they have a lot of pent-up energy and might get frustrated, so the best way to combat this is lots of playtime and interaction with both you and maybe other pets. Like I said before, if you're thinking of adopting a special needs cat, you need to really clear yourself up on what it is that your cat is dealing with. So for example, Wobble, who's a cat with cerebral palsy, she gets extra food and extra nutrition because she doesn't walk or move around so much. Because she can't stand and walk by herself, her meal times are supervised and on a very strict schedule. She gets extra food because she loses a lot of weight because she's constantly moving with her wobbling around. So she gets extra chicken and tuna and extra food. All of her meal times are supervised and she is giving a little bit of a helping hand. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope that you enjoyed these tips. Let me know in the comment section below if you've got any additional ones. Let me know if you have a special needs cat and I'd like to know. Now it's that time to announce the winner of the Relax My Cat t-shirt competition. I'll just remind you of the rules if you have forgotten them or you're new here. Make sure that you are subscribed to Relax My Cat YouTube channel and that you have notifications on so you get a notification whenever one of our videos comes out. And most importantly, you need to comment on this video in the first 16 minutes that it's up. Follow these rules, you are in with a chance of winning your very own t-shirt. Now let's see who's won this week. Now I had some wonderful comments on my last video, but one really stuck out, and that was from Kitten Foster Mom, which is wonderful. She says that they call those crazy times zoomies, which I thought was really, really funny. When our cats go crazy, we call them looping, that they're going a bit loopy. I love that. So congratulations to Kitten Foster Mom, you've won yourself a t-shirt. Now all you need to do is email us at relaxmycat@gmail.com with your size and your address, and we'll send it over to you. Thanks again for watching, guys. If you did enjoy the video, please give us a big thumbs up. Head on over to Google to give us a Google review. And don't forget to subscribe and comment. Rexy's done, and we'll see you next week. Bye.